What's up, guys? Today I'm gonna be showing you this little program that I made. It's pretty cool. I'm not gonna attempt to explain it very much, hopefully, but as you can see, it looks somewhat like Minecraft. It is definitely inspired by Minecraft. I mean, these textures I just found on Google Images, and they are not Minecraft textures. I just downsampled like high resolution textures to get these. But yeah, check that out. As you can see, the lighting is quite good. I do ray tracing with this. Pretty cool. It's kind of slow, but whatever. My graphics card isn't that good. Probably only worth like $70 on eBay. Holy crap, look at that. Wow, nice. Nice. Oh yeah, and I added a block which emits light. Ooh, that's not it. That's it. That's the ticket. I see. Oh, I placed a bunch of them all around, I think. Jesus Christ. Wow. It's like Minecraft. You can place blocks. You cannot break blocks because it is not like Minecraft. you know, close enough. I tried. I think I could add it quite, but it would just be a little bit of effort, and not trying to do that right now. The ability to delete blocks. Oh yeah, so I'm gonna say some specs. I have an AMD graphics card. I made this program to be able to be run on anybody's computer. I don't know, maybe not anybody's if your computer's really old, I guess. But here you can see the Octree that I used. Oh shoot, what the heck is going on? I'm going inside that thing. Okay, as you can see, oh my god. The world is kind of sliced up into smaller cubes on here, and here we see a cross section. And it's only sliced up further if there's more detail required there. So if I just place a block here, as you can see, you can only see from like low angles. This is like some artifact in my walls. I don't know why it's here, but it is a good thing because it kind of shows the structure of the world. So it kind of slices the world up only where it needs to, so I can get there. That way, if you're a ray, normally without the Octree, you would have to step through each block and check if there was a block there. You'd have to check through each space in the grid. This way, you can just step through these entire large areas in just one step. And then you can see it. Oh, I just passed right by there. But if I was going through here, you know, it wouldn't take as many steps as if I stepped through every single block. So that's the advantage of using the Octree, basically. And it's what allows me to do this in real time. Even though it's not that good, it's quite grainy and noisy, as you can see. But there are filtering techniques that you can use. Call it denoising. There's a lot of ways of doing it. And I haven't applied any of those techniques, so that's why it's quite grainy. Look at that. The only technique I used is shooting out more rays. So let's check it out when we max out how many rays we're shooting out. So right now we're doing 25. Let's go for 70. That's not really maxing it out. I've tried higher than that, but you can try that on your computer if you like. Where is this? 1280, yeah. Wouldn't be any fun if it wasn't good high resolution. As you can see, there's no noise anymore. Or not nearly as much noise. Practically none. But one way to see that is we can add a light block. There we go. And see, yes, there is some noise. but not too much. It's not too bad. Ooh, it's quite bright there. The cool, funny thing about the lamps is they light each other up, so they kind of like add. It's really slow, obviously, right now, because it's shooting out 75 rays for every single pixel you see on the screen. So there's already almost a million in a 720p screen. There's already almost a million pixels. For each one, it's shooting out 75 rays once it hits a surface, if it does hit a surface. 75 rays. And then if those other rays hit a surface, then those rays have to shoot up towards the sun and see if there's something in the way. And so all of that is, you know, it's hundreds, at the most, I think it's 750 steps through the cells of the world, the octree cells. So like, they could be big steps or small steps, but in the maximum, oh, actually for right now, it could be a much higher than 750. I didn't calculate it for this. But yeah, there's a lot of steps and it's a lot of work. So if you have a nicer graphics card that you spent a few hundred dollars on, then this program will run much faster. But yeah, you basically have seen everything there is you can do in this program. Place a bunch of blocks. Alright, thanks for watching, guys. Haha.